on, Nicole.
Wow.
Come on. Robert and Nicole, you guys have danced beautifully tonight and you really gave it all tonight. And Nicole, I can see that you're really upset. You've come all the way back from Italy for this. Was it worth it? Did you have a great time?
I had the most amazing time.
White shopping.
Oh, Nicole, and I was there.
So we have with us now the latest contestants to be eliminated from Dancing with the Stars, Robert Dorakety. He is here along with his dance partner, Nicole. Welcome to you both.
Yes.
Just watch that bit when you're eliminated. We can be honest here, I think. I think the whole country can be honest. Didn't expect to see you sitting here this week. I think we've said that for the last few weeks, though.
Yeah.
You got your highest scores ever last night.
Yeah, we got 22. We got actually someone gave us an 8, which is like, ooh. We got a lot of 7s. We got a lot of
strong 7s.
But I would be happy with a limp 8.
As
a flaccid 9.
Yeah.
You know,
or a tip of 10 maybe.
Tip of 10 maybe.
You always look like you're having fun though. So was it fun, or is it hard work?
Yes and yes, it's both. It was a lot of fun because you make it fun. Nicole made it fun. And there's a lot of pressure because you've got to learn a dance routine. 90 seconds, at first I was like,
90 seconds.
The song.
Exactly, but
do
then then do it fast with bedazzlement on. It changed it for me. But yeah, it was indeed a lot of fun. Yeah.
Nicole, can you tell us a little bit about how was it when you first saw that you were going to be dancing with Robert? How did you feel?
I was really happy, actually, because we did the promo shoot with my dance partner, Fabio, and I saw Robert's, you know, little Michael Jackson thing, and I thought, this guy, he can move.
And so then did you go and Google him to see exactly what he'd done?
Yep, and YouTube. And there was one video, actually, when he's singing. Well, and the hips are moving, and I was like, that is great Cuban hip action.
And then, for some reason, when I started Dancing with the Stars, I forgot to move my hips.
It was lacking.
My hip action was lacking, so.
Well, and that's the thing with you.
Exactly.
Everything, Robert, that you've done over the years, you know, you've always been very good at it. But, you know, I guess you're trying to squeeze in your radio show, rehearsals, you've got a lot going on. On the scale of being disappointed that you didn't make it and being relieved that it's over, where do you sit?
I'm disappointed, weighted more towards disappointment, because you don't do a show like Dancing with the Stars and commit that much time and energy, and you don't see your family, and you know we're in each other's faces for, you know, 6-7 hours a day, 7 days a week. You don't put that much effort in just to give it a crack.
Right.
Yeah. You want to win it. And so I am disappointed for both of us, for Nicole, because she's worked so hard, because dancing's her passion, this is her life. It was I'm all strapped up with my knee brace on and strapping on my back and my feet going, why do you put yourself through this? But it brings you pleasure, right?
That
you
is your life.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
That is my life.
Obviously very, very important that you have a good relationship together and that you also probably have a good relationship with Robert's wife as well.
Oh, yeah.
We did that first.
We made sure that, well, actually it was Robert who said, you know, I'd really like for you and my partner Fabio to come over and...
Yeah,
they'd
come over for dinner and stuff, and my wife Nikki would come to our practices, sit there, and we got home one night, she goes, oh, your arms need to be more forward. I'm like,
oh, right.
I wish she'd been able to come the whole time, because she made him do his homework.
Yeah, and then the next day, this one goes, your arms need to be forward, and my wife looks at me and goes,
So you had an entourage, didn't you?
I just told you that.
Good support system in place.
Yeah.
And is it true that, you know, doing the show was a secret, that, you know, a secret little passion that you had, Robert?
It's something that I thought would be a real challenge to do. So when they asked me to do it, the first person I talked to was my wife, Nikki, because I'm not going to be home, so she has to, you know, take over everything. But when everything was okayed by the boss, it was good to get out. Yeah, it's something I wanted to do, and I've learned so much. And it's a challenge. And it's proven that if you apply yourself, you genuinely can do. I couldn't do a quick step before to save myself. So the judges would say I still can't.
But when you get to weddings and to 21st parties, you're going to be busting out some sweet dance moves.
It's when I put my wife up and put her on the table. People go, what is he doing?
Show pony.
Unbutton the shirt down
here.
Yeah.
Oh, speaking of other things that you can do, obviously you do your breakfast radio show, so you're getting up at what, 4:30
in the morning?
Yeah, that
goes off just after 4,
And then dancing all day. I mean, so you must have been surviving for these last few weeks on little or no sleep.
Chocolate. Chocolate's a secret to being a good dancer on little sleep. But this one here, you would see me, right, hit the wall later in the afternoon and nothing was going in.
What did you do, hold his nose and put chocolate in there?
I just said chocolate. Oh, yes, please. No need to hold the nose.
How would you respond to the one of the reviewers calling you a dead man dancing?
There was no
Robert there. How do you feel about that?
You know, I get what he's saying, but you can't fake who you are. I can't be more dramatic. It's just who I am. I'm just a laid-back dude. And
someone people called you a dead man dancing?
Yes. Yes.
Really?
Yes.
We'll hunt them down later on.
but it's people like the drama, and you have to tell a story. And then I was just being myself, and maybe perhaps for some folks it wasn't enough.
You don't look like you're a dead man dancing there just quietly. But you've got a lot of other things going on in life too, including, of course, being a brown wiggle. Where are you at with the brown wiggle? I'm glad that you wore this today, just to remind
this
us.
This is
a mustard wiggle.
This is like baby poo mustard.
Baby poo. So where are the wiggles at the moment? Where are you as a brown wiggle?
Well, the wiggles are in America touring, and I'm here.
Okay. And there you go. Toast dancing on the stars of the Wiggles fame. Okay.
And Nicole, what do you think was his best dance?
Oh, it would be between the jive and the Argentine tango. I think that on the night, the jive, he just put so much pressure on himself. He did, you know, have a few little stumbles. Whereas the Argentine tango, he just pulled
Nailed
off.
It. Nailed regularly. It. Yeah. And finally, just very quickly, we ask this every week, who do you think is going to win?
Jess or Susie.
There you go. Oh, a definitive answer. Okay. We like that. Much of the skirt around that.
Well, thanks, guys. It's been a pleasure having you in here, even though, you know, we don't want to have you in here. It's been nice to see you.
Thank you.
If that
great,
makes
mate.
Sense.
Loved it.
I'll make sure you keep watching Dancing with the Stars. Sundays at 7 and Mondays at 7:30 on 3. And don't forget, you can catch any episodes that you've missed on 3 Now.